why this is so important is that this is a community-driven analysis of what is our condition and what we need to do to make the life and living of black people better.
There's two conversations going on. It's what non-black people say we are, and it's what we say we are if we're authentic. No, I don't envy nobody else, but I know that I came from heaven to do this work. But the fact of the matter is that the reparations of money is not going to address the deep-sighted scars. I'm going to show you in a moment what I mean, that our people suffer from.
And I just heard Dr. Wade Noble speak. I learned a lot from Dr. Noble's. The importance of self, the importance of history, the importance of family, the importance of African culture, how to retrieve our African culture, how to teach people younger than myself the importance of respecting our elders, learning from our elders. Dr. Noble's was very powerful. His speech was very informative, and he really moved me to learn more of his writing.
Community activists coming together in the same space and talking about solutions.
My name is Dr. Joy Angela DeGruy. I am an assistant professor at Portland State University in the School of Social Work.
African Americans continue to suffer from the consequences of slavery and for long after both systems were formally abolished. There are enormous damage and loss, both tangible and intangible, including the loss of human dignity and liberty.
And when we think about African Americans, my father used to often say, if a white man has a cold, a black man has pneumonia. We need to have a plan B.
We need more this dialogue. But also we need to focus on how we get our own resources in order to make the transition happen.
I think it's important to have these conversations because of the need to move things forward.
So this needs to be a continual conversation that we have.
I'm Deborah Prothrow-Stith. I'm a consultant at Spencer Stuart and adjunct professor at the Harvard School of Public Health.
And we've got to flip that switch and become the researchers. Because don't let somebody tell you math is not for you. And don't let somebody tell you science is not for you. And don't let anybody tell you that research is too hard. Don't do that!
And my perspective of this conference is that I'm learning how to be a better leader, how black youth need to get it together as far as education and take it seriously.
From a young black male's perspective, I'm actually getting a lot out of this conference. I'm learning that there are people that look like me.
This kind of meeting is extremely important, not only for the exchange of ideas, but for the exchange of strategies as well.
We thought it was paramount that we expose our children to this conference because it's talking about those circumstances, real world circumstances that they wrestle with each and every day.
The Community Empowerment Conference is a wonderful opportunity for the community to come together.
No, we got some serious challenges. We're not well.
We had more of our African-American students who were being disciplined and compared to their white counterparts.
This conference, mitigating the social and psychological trauma on the fabric of the African-American community, was a success. We had 2.5 days. We had Wade Nobles with us, Dr. Nobles. We had Dr. DeGruy, and also we had Dr. Deborah Prothrow-Smith. And it was a diverse group of people that was here that shared a lot of information on best practices and some of the work that we're doing on the ground. And I think everyone took home something and looking forward to having conferences and discussions like this in the future.
Take everything serious. Don't take no breaks off. Go hard. Everything you do. Inflation. No change.